when I'm underneath the bright lights, when I'm trying to have a good time. Cause I'm good now, you ain't mine.
Nah, 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 nah. Don't call me up
when you're looking at the photos. Lost is in control. You want me more now, I let go now.
Well, good evening, Sumter School District boys and girls, and welcome to a very special evening of reading with the superintendent. Tonight is our very, very first time returning to evening reading, and I want to make sure that we continue to engage our minds during the holidays. So please join us every evening during the holidays so we can continue to read. And tonight, I have a very special, special guest joining us. We have with us Lee Corporal Adams from the Sumter City Police Department. Well, good evening, Corporal Adams. How are you doing?
I'm doing well, ma'am. How are you? Hi, boys and girls.
I'm excited, and I know our audience is excited. So why don't you take this opportunity to share with them why I'm so excited to have you here.
Hi. Okay, I am Lead Corporal Tabitha King Adams with the Sumter Police Department. I'm also a school resource officer at Sumter High School. And today we'll be reading that I wrote, The Adventures of Officer King, The Case of the Missing Number 3. Yes.
Well, this is exciting. First of all, you're considered an author because of this wonderful literature that you've produced.
Yes,
but
ma'am.
I think we need to figure out why the number 3 is missing and what's happening here. So are you ready so we can begin to do this?
I am ready.
Are you okay? So we have to do one thing first, Corporal Adams. And we have to make sure that I have the attention of everyone who's watching. Okay?
Yes,
so
ma'am.
You I do, and maybe some of them have forgotten, and maybe we have someone who's new, but I need to call their attention. So I usually call, and you respond, 1, 2, 3, all eyes on me.
1, 2, all eyes on you.
Now you can begin reading because we have everyone's attention.
All right. The Adventures of Officer King and the Case of the Missing Number 3. Woo. Let's begin. It was a bright summer day. Officer King was in the park eating lunch and enjoying the scenery on our downtime. What a beautiful day, said Officer King. The birds are chirping and the sun is shining so bright. I don't think anything can possibly go wrong.
Well, I'm just wondering, Corporal Adams, do you have days where nothing goes wrong?
We have days that I want to assume nothing will go wrong, but they end up going wrong. So it's okay because Officer King is here to save the day.
As Officer King continues to eat her lunch, she receives a call over the radio from dispatch. Officer King, said dispatch, please prepare for a call. Ready to copy, dispatch, she replied. Officer King, the numbers called and stated they have an emergency. They cannot locate the missing number 3. They need you to help to locate the number or the world is doomed. The numbers are gathered at Sires Park. Copy, dispatch, said Officer King. I am already on the scene at the park, and I will look for the numbers. You know, I've always wanted to be, you know, on the radio and calling, so I can be dispatch one day, because this felt good doing that.
Officer King hurried and packed up her lunch. She then walked around the park until she was able to locate the numbers sitting under a palm tree. Hi, I'm Officer King, she said. How may I help you all? Number 1 walked up in a panic and shouted, I am the leader of the numbers, and it is my my responsibility to make sure that we have everyone accounted for. Our poor friend number three is missing. When did you last see number three? Asked Officer King. All of the numbers take a break every day at 2 p.m. to play hide and go seek. We found all the numbers except three. We must find three before the clock strikes 3 p.m. or the world will be in an uproar.
Well, we can't have the world in an uproar.
No, ma'am.
Maintain as much peace as we possibly can.
Yes, yes.
Officer King immediately began to interview the rest of the numbers. She attempted to gather clues on whereabouts of the number three. So we have 7, 4, 9, 5, 2, 6, 8. They've gathered.
Oh, peace is getting good. I'm getting nervous. After interviewing the numbers, Officer King realized she did not have enough evidence gathered. Okay, number three. It was time to search the park up and down to locate number three. Officer King searched the playground area and was unsuccessful in finding number three.
Well, I can say one thing. Officer King is very determined.
Yes, she is.
Stop eating her lunch to go find number three.
Gotta save the world.
Save the world. Make sure there's peace. Officer King searched the basketball and tennis courts area. Still, no luck. Number three! Officer King looked in the restroom. Number three was not there. Oh, number three. I wonder where three could be.
I got it, screamed Officer King. I will search the palm tree area where I first gathered with the numbers. Officer King ran fast as she can to the palm tree area. She climbed every single tree and still was not able to find number three. Began to feel sad. She doesn't want to disappoint the world.
That's a lot of pressure to work every day to make sure you serve and protect and save the world. Like, I wonder if I can hold this radio. You know, I used to, when I was a principal, have a radio, and you couldn't tell me I wasn't important when I carried my radio. And I believe my staff who had the other ends, they used to turn them off at certain times during the day, but that's another conversation for a later date. Officer King decided to inform the other police officers about number three being missing. She sent out a bolo. Okay, I'm gonna tell you, I know what a bolo is. Can I tell you what a bolo is? Be on the lookout. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
I told you I wanted to be dispatched, which means to be on the lookout to the other officers. Officers, be on the lookout for number three. The subject was last seen at Sires Park playing hide and go seek with the rest of the numbers. Number three is yellow with dark brown eyes. Please advise me if number three is located. Good description.
Yes.
On the bolo.
Good description if somebody goes missing, okay?
Is this what you normally do when someone goes missing? You give a description like that?
Yes, ma'am. Over that radio that we're going to get you one of. You send a bolo out. That means be on the lookout, okay? And you give a good description. So just in case the other officers find them, they can call you back on the radio and say, hey, I got this person.
So I'm going to tell a little secret about the radio.
Mm-hmm.
There's one in my house. Belongs to my husband.
Really?
Look at it all the time, but I won't touch it because I'm afraid that I'm going to do something wrong, but I've been tempted to touch it, which don't tell him.
Okay, I won't. Secret safe with me.
Officer sat and pondered on where number three could be. That's a nice vocabulary word, pondered.
Yes. She thought about it. She was thinking and thinking. Officer King walked back to where the numbers were gathered and asked, is there anything at all that I need to know about number three that no one has told me? Three is a very deep sleeper, said number four. It's sometimes difficult to wake number three, so I could replace him at 4 p.m. Three is also very competitive and always looks for difficult places to hide during the game, said number two.
Number two seems to be helpful. Okay. Officer King thought long and hard on where to search next. It was now 2:53 p.m., and Officer King only had 6 minutes to find three and save the world of tragedy. That is a lot of pressure.
My heart is beating so fast right now. Where is number three? If I were number three and I wanted to hide where no one could find me, where would I hide? Officer King said to herself.
Good thinking. So I just hope that number three has not gotten into danger. And I'll tell you a story about hide and go seek in my house with my son when he was very little. It ended well, but it sent me in a little hysteria because I was everywhere in the house. And guess where he was? In the bathtub.
Oh, good. Now, that was a good one.
Yeah, it was good when I found him, but I was really nervous. Like Officer King, she's nervous.
Right.
Officer King ran to number eight and politely asked him to turn around. Sleeping behind number eight was number three. Number three woke up and said, I decided that hiding behind number eight would make it hard to find me because I could easily blend in with eight. I must have fallen asleep. I'm sorry. You see that? You see the eight? And then you see the three? That was a great way to camouflage.
Yeah, three is a slick one. That was good.
It was. I'm just glad number three is safe.
Me too. Officer King and the numbers rejoiced. The world was saved and three made it before the top of the hour. All ended well. Officer King was happy, and she called dispatch over the radio. Dispatch, we located number three, and everything was 10-4, said Officer King. Dispatch replied, copy. Thank you.
All before the world was chaotic. That was a lot of work and good work, Officer King. So, this was a very, very good book to read. Why don't you take the opportunity to share with our people who may be watching ways in which they can be safe, and if they're lost, what should they do?
All right. Okay, so to be safe, if you're walking down the street, try to walk with the buddy. We always want to use the buddy system. The buddy system is excellent, okay? Never talk to strangers. Don't accept anything from strangers, no candy, water, nothing. If you don't know them, don't speak to them, okay? If somebody tries to get you to come with them, you shout stranger danger and you run as fast as you can, all right? And always try to stay close, near to your parents, mom and dad, your guardian, whoever. Try to stay as close as you can to them. I know you like to wander, because I like to wander around too, but it's all about being safe, okay? Safe, 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 all right?
I think those are great pointers. And so, you know, that's what you do each and every day. So I want to take the opportunity to first and foremost, thank you for what you do each and every day by making sure that we are safe. But I also want to commend you for being a role model, which is something that, you know, women and little girls can look up to, but also our little boys and our young men. They have positive role models to look up to. So I just want to thank you for what you do each and every day when you step out into the world to make sure everyone is safe. So thank you for what you do. I also thank you for being the author of this wonderful book. Thank you for sharing the work that's necessary to keep our children safe. So this is actually applicable to real world experiences, because oftentimes, particularly around these times of years and the holidays, it's so much excitement out there. And because we're still working through the coronavirus, I don't know what shopping will look like or what the streets will look like, because those are the opportunities when someone will offer a toy or a candy to get our young people to come with them. And I just want them to remember what it is that you've shared. And so thank you for being the author of this wonderful, wonderful book. And I hope that the audience enjoyed it as much as I did in terms of reading with you. So thank you again.
Thank you. And I'm glad to be
here. Are there any words you'd like to share?
Yes, I'm glad to have experienced this. This was so much fun. And I appreciate everything. And boys and girls, make sure that you're also safe. Make sure we keep our masks on and make sure we use our hand sanitizers like this one here. Spread kindness and not germs. All right?
Is that Officer King?
That is Officer King.
I thought she looked familiar.
Yes.
So thank you again, Corporal Adams, for sharing your very special time with us. I know we've enjoyed reading this with you, and let's make sure we plan a date to do it again in the very near future. Is that a plan?
Right. That's a bet. I can arrange that.
Okay. So boys and girls, thank you for watching another evening with the superintendent. Thank you again, Corporal Adams, and thank you all for watching, and I'll see you very soon on another evening of Reading with the Superintendent. Take care. Thank you, Corporal Adams.
Thank you.